Over the last few years, AI has completely reshaped how interior designers work. What used to take hours hunting for suppliers, structuring client notes, fixing images, or building presentations can now happen in minutes. I'm Joanne from Design Inc. Co., and today I'm showing you the AI tools I think every designer should be using right now. Whether you're running a solo studio, managing multiple projects, or trying to streamline your creative workflow. These tools will help with concept development, client meetings, project organizations, mood boards, and day-to-day studio systems. Let's get started. ChatGPT in 2026 is far more powerful than it was even a year ago, and it is becoming one of the most essential tools in a designer's workflow. Here are the ways I use it every day. Number one, brainstorming concepts. When I'm developing a concept or I'm stuck between directions, I describe the space, constraints, style goals, and materials. ChatGPT helps me generate possible directions, palettes, mood words, narratives, and visual descriptors. It's like having a second designer in the room to bounce off ideas. Instead of staring at a blank page, I paste my keywords or reference images and let it draft clear, client-ready explanations for concepts, materiality, and layout rationale. Summarizing client briefs. If you receive a long email, a multi-page PDF, or scattered WhatsApp messages, ChatGPT can extract every requirement, constraint, and decision point into a single structured summary. Meeting prep. I drop in the agenda, the project overview, and my outstanding questions, and it helps me outline talking points so I enter meetings clear and confident. I upload an image and ChatGPT identifies the style, the designer, possible products or alternative options available locally or within budget. Need local suppliers in another country, timber alternatives that meet a fire rating, sustainable materials for a coastal climate? ChatGPT pulls together clear, scannable lists with pros and cons. As you know, replying and writing emails takes up a major proportion of any designer's day. I use an email bank called Prospect to Project, which is housed in my Notion workspace that helps me keep on track. It has draft emails for every stage of the design process. It gives me the basic outline, and I can use ChatGPT to help me refine it even further. If you want a copy of Prospect Project, there's a link in the description for you to check out. This tool alone saves me hours each week. Tool number two, AI meeting assistance, turning every meeting into actionable notes. One of the biggest time drains in design studios is meetings, client meetings, trade calls, site walkthroughs, internal coordination. It all adds up. In 2026, Meeting AI has finally become reliable. There are many ways to use this. You can use a tool like Fathom, which is embedded directly into Zoom. And I use the meeting function in Notion, which records the meeting and drops the transcript and the summary immediately into my workspace. You can also use an app like Mac Whisper or Super Whisper on your phone or computer to record meetings if you are on site and then process it using ChatGPT to drop into your notes later. Here's how I use it. I record online meetings or site visits and send the audio into ChatGPT or an AI meeting tool, and it returns a clean transcript, all decisions made, all action items, all unresolved questions, everything I have to follow up on, and this becomes the backbone of my project documentation. Once I had the summary, I head over to my Prospect to Project email database and I grab my meeting updates and email. I load all of the information into ChatGPT, then I ask it to write a short professional follow-up with decisions, next steps, and deadlines. It keeps your client communications tight and consistent. I feed my meeting summaries directly into Notion to update project scopes, change logs, and timelines. Meetings feel lighter when you know everything is captured accurately. Tool number three, Notion, your AI-powered studio brain. Notion has become my design studio hub. Now with AI built directly in, it's now capable of handling a huge amount of your operational workflow, and it can help you set up your AI databases and workspaces. How designers can use Notion with AI right now. Project dashboards. With Notion's AI templates, you can build dynamic dashboards that pull from your tasks, meeting notes, timelines, and client info. Everything is connected. Material and resource libraries. Instead of saving bookmarks all over your browser, you can create a searchable database of suppliers, products, materials, finishes, textiles and lighting references. AI will tag items automatically, extract metadata, generate short descriptions, link related products, keep track of price changes, paste any client questionnaire or text, and Notion AI will convert it into a clean brief with all the requirements captured. Studio systems. From content trackers to financial trackers to mood board libraries, Notion becomes the operating system of your studio. AI keeps everything organized and up to date. If you're running a design business, Notion is one of the highest leverage tools you can adopt. Tool number four, image generation and editing. Image generation and image editing has come a long way in a year and will no doubt future develop. It seems like there's a new tool every month. It has become a critical part of design, especially for concept development and visual direction, as well as image editing. For concept development, I tend to use MidJourney. It has the most aesthetically pleasing results, and you can train the model to understand your own taste using the mood board tool. You can use it for style exploration, describe your project and generate multiple visual directions in seconds. Materiality studies. Upload materials or mood board components and ask MidJourney to combine them into an interior concept. Layout ideation, using references, sketches, or existing project photos to explore alternatives. It's not construction accurate, but it's amazing for mood, composition, and early concept validation. On-brand concept boards. You can build consistent visual narratives using style references and seed controls, perfect for early presentations. If you want to learn more about MidJourney, you can check out this video you'll find up here. One thing that MidJourney isn't great at is editing images. This is where I use a tool like NanoBanana. Upload a site photo or reference image and adjust materials, lighting, furniture or styling to test ideas quickly. Remember, these tools are creativity amplifiers, not a replacement for your expertise. Tool number five, Canva. Canva remains one of the most efficient tools for presentation-ready visuals, and it has a lot of AI features built right in. Here's how I use Canva with AI. I use the background remover for furniture, decor, and materials. You can isolate objects in seconds without having to jump into Photoshop. Automatic layout generation. Upload your images and Canva AI generates mood board layouts you can tweak. Brand kits for your studio. Keep your brand colors, typography, and styles consistent across proposals, presentations, and social content. I often create clean object cutouts and simple layouts in Canva and then move them into InDesign for more polished presentations. To make this practical, here's how a real project might flow. Number one, the client sends a long brief. I add it to ChatGPT for a clean summary. Number two, meeting with the client. I record the session and process the transcript with AI. Number three, I update the project dashboard. Meetings, summaries, and decisions go straight into Notion. Number four, concept development. I build initial narratives in ChatGPT and explore visuals in MidJourney, editing any images using NanoBanana in Photoshop. Early mood boards. I then create cutouts and quick layouts in Canva. Final presentations. I upload everything into my final presentation in InDesign, or you could use any preferred software you would like. This workflow alone can save you 5 to 10 hours per week. If you want to learn how to use these tools properly and build them into a professional design workflow for your interior design business, I teach all of this inside my free community, the Design Success Circle. I'll leave a link in the description so that you can join. And if you want to learn how to use NanoBanana in your design business, you should watch this video next.